27th Conference of Speakers and Presiding Officers of the Commonwealth, which has been going on in Munyonyo, Kampala, has come to an end today. The four-day conference, attended by over 50 speakers and their deputies from countries like Nigeria, Pakistan, Rwanda, Singapore, South Africa, Malaysia, among others, discussed a range of topics including climate change mitigation, consensus building in the houses, welfare of MPs and security of parliaments, among others. The President of the Senate of Malaysia, Dr. Wan Junaid, and the Speaker of the House of Representatives of Malaysia, Johari bin Abdul, ended their stay in Uganda with a guided tour of the parliament building, and they were impressed with the way Uganda has conserved its parliament in traditional shape.
The number of members, which is exceeding the number of seats, and therefore your arrangement is completely different from what we saw. But then again, the arrangement inside, with the table right center, the mess there, and it looked like a real British tradition in the members on the house.
They applauded Ugandans for the hospitality exhibited to them and commended the Speaker of the Parliament of Uganda for a remarkable conference.
He has been very kind, and the visit to this conference was very meaningful, and this is very historical building, and there are so many things that we can learn from Uganda. And I guess the relationship between Malaysia and Uganda can be better in future, inshallah. And I guess the speaker has shown interest in governing everybody.
Thank you for
But anyway, I would like to say thank you very much to Parliament and members of Parliament for having given us the opportunity and the hospitality they accorded to us, especially the speaker herself and the members of Parliament, who make our stay here very, very pleasant and very, very welcome.
The Speaker of Malaysia commended the unity of Ugandans in diversity of tribes and religions and underscored Uganda's development potential. He pledged to woo Malaysian investors to invest in bankable projects and also promote bilateral trade.
Current leadership, I believe Uganda will be one of the most respected country in Africa. And we are working hard to talk about economic development. And in fact, I'm talking to many entrepreneurs here, how do we can work together so that we and Ugandan and also other parts of the of Asia can come and invest here.
Johari tipped Ugandans to benchmark for skills in countries like Asian tigers that gained a high rate of economic growth at a wonderful speed to join the ranks of the richest countries in the world.
What we need to do is exposure. This is where I think Ugandans should go out and see the world. See what's happening in China, see what's happening in Korea, in Malaysia, in South Asia. And I think you have a lot of asset here, a lot of opportunity here. The only thing that's lacking probably the knowledge and technology.
He implored Uganda to utilize a number of Ugandans that have studied in Malaysia, where they have gained top entrepreneur skills in its development agenda.
We had many Ugandan students who studied in Malaysia, and they are back now. And these are the people who should spearhead the entrepreneurship here. Because you have the asset, but if you do not have the technological know-how and the connection, then we hinders your development.
In the financial year 2022-2023, Uganda fetched $22.4 million from exports to Malaysia and imported goods worth $248.8 million in the same year. Story compiled by Fred Kajubi for the news.